Hello friends and my dear students, welcome back to my channel Phoenix Physics. Today we are going to learn conductors at electrostatic equilibrium. You know that conductors conduct electricity and heat. Metals are very good conductors. Example, copper, aluminium, iron, all the metals are a very good conductor. Why do they conduct electricity? Because it has large number of charge carriers. In a metallic conductor, these charge carriers are called as free electrons, which are not bound to any atom. These free electrons are in the outermost shell called valence electron. They can move freely within the conductor but not free to leave the metal. In general, conductors conduct electricity and heat because it has large number of free electrons. Next, we will discuss two cases. Suppose if there is no external electric field, which means E is equal to zero. These free electrons are in continuous random motion in all the directions. As a result, there is no net motion of electron along any particular direction. It is said to be electrostatic equilibrium. So how do you say the conductor is at the electrostatic equilibrium? When there is no net motion of electron along any particular direction, means the conductor is said to be in electrostatic equilibrium. You know that electrostatic means charges are at rest. Equilibrium means net force is equal to zero. So at electrostatic equilibrium, there is no net current in the conductor. This is very, very important. At electrostatic equilibrium, there is no net current in the conductor. So first case, E is equal to zero. Suppose E is not equal to zero means there will be a force on the charge due to this electric field E, and the force is F is equal to EQ. I hope you know that. As a result, there will be a net motion of electrons in a particular direction, which contradicts to our electrostatic equilibrium condition. You know that electrostatic equilibrium means no net current in the conductor. Suppose E is not equal to zero means the electrons move in a particular direction, we can get net current in that direction, which contradicts to electrostatic equilibrium. So what is our conclusion? E is equal to zero inside the conductor. This is our conclusion. So far we discussed about what is conductors, then you know the meaning of electrostatic equilibrium. Next we will discuss some important properties. First one, the electric field E is zero inside the conductor. This is true whether the conductor is solid or hollow. Here, before applying electric field, the free electrons in the conductors are uniformly distributed and move in the random direction like this. I am going to place this conductor in a uniform electric field like this.
Field lines
start at plus charge and end at negative. So this side you have plus and this side you have minus. Now the free electrons inside the conductors are attracted towards this positive charge and arranged in the left side of the conductor. Same way, the positive charges are arranged in the right side of the conductor. This is my E external. Here I have plus charge and here I have minus charge. Due to this realignment, internal electric field is produced inside the conductor and the direction is like this. This is my E internal electric field direction. So look at the diagram. Here this E internal is opposite to E external. Then how do you calculate the total electric field? The total electric field is E is equal to zero, because the external electric field is nullified by internal electric field. The conductor is said to be in electrostatic equilibrium. And one more thing, the time taken to reach this electrostatic equilibrium is in the order of 10 to the power of minus 16 second. It is very small time interval. We can say this time is instantaneous time. Next property, there is no net charge inside the conductor. The charges must reside on the surface of the conductor. For this, consider an arbitrary shaped conductor like this. This conductor is placed in a uniform electric field E. Due to this field, positive charges are arranged in the right side of the conductor, negative charges are arranged in the left side of the conductor. I hope you know that. Imagine one Gaussian surface is drawn inside the conductor like this. This is my Gaussian surface. Inside the conductor, you know that E is equal to zero. This is our first property. Same way, inside the Gaussian surface, there is no net charge. Or we can say the net charge inside the conductor is zero, which means Q is equal to zero. Then how do you calculate electric flux? You know Gauss law. What is our Gauss law? That is phi is equal to integral E dot dA, that is equal to Q by epsilon naught. Here E is equal to zero inside the conductor. Same way Q is equal to zero inside the conductor. Then obviously the electric flux phi is equal to zero. This is our second condition. Suppose if you introduce excess charge inside the conductor, say I am going to introduce one Q, immediately reaches the surface of the conductor. So we can conclude that E is equal to zero, Q is equal to zero inside the conductor. So the electric flux phi is equal to zero. This is our second property. Third property, the electric field outside the conductor is perpendicular to the surface and has the magnitude sigma by epsilon naught. Here I have spherical conductor. Plus Q charge is uniformly distributed on the surface of the conductor. Then how do you draw electric field lines? Q is positive means E is radially outward. So E direction is radially outward like this. And it makes an angle 90 degree. E makes an angle 90 degree with the surface of the conductor. This is our first line. Same way, here I have spherical shaped conductor. Inside the sphere, I have minus Q charges. So minus Q charges are distributed on the surface of the conductor. Then how do you draw electric field lines? If it is minus means electric field lines radially inward. Whether it is outward or inward, it is always perpendicular to the surface. Perpendicular means it makes an angle 90 degree. See, here at the center you can get straight line. At the edges, which means the top and bottom side, electric field lines bend like this. This line makes an angle 90 degree with the surface. This is our first line. Suppose the conductor is like this. On the surface, I have plus Q charges. Here I have plus charges. So electric field line is like this. It makes an angle theta with the surface. So you can easily separate E into two components. One is parallel component, another one is perpendicular component. You know that E is equal to 0 inside the conductor. If you have parallel component of electric field, whether it is parallel or tangential, both are same. The charge will move in this direction. So you can get the current flow is in this direction. However, no such current exists under static condition, or we can say this one violates our electrostatic equilibrium condition. Electrostatic equilibrium means there is no net current inside the conductor. Suppose if you have parallel component of electric field, means you can get current in this direction. So it violates the electrostatic equilibrium condition. So we can conclude that electric field is always normal to the conductor. This one is possible. This is not possible. Now I am going to calculate electric field outside the conductor. See, this is my conductor. I am going to calculate electric field at this point. I am going to apply Gauss law, that is phi is equal to integral E dot dA, that is equal to Q by epsilon naught. Suppose if you want to apply Gauss law, means you need Gaussian surface. For this point, I am going to draw cylindrical Gaussian surface like this. It is very small cylindrical Gaussian surface. So the bottom of the cylinder is embedded inside the conductor. You know that E is equal to 0 inside the conductor. So the bottom of the cylinder is embedded inside the conductor. Now this Gaussian surface has three parts. One is top surface, second one curved surface, another one is bottom. This bottom portion is embedded inside the conductor. How do you write the integral term? That is phi is equal to integral E dA cos theta. This is for top surface, plus E dA cos theta curved surface, plus E dA cos theta, this is for bottom surface. That is equal to Q by epsilon naught. Here, at the top surface, you consider one small area, say dA. You draw one line, that is n cap. It is nothing but unit vector. Now dA becomes dA vector, area vector. The angle between E and n cap is 0 degree. So at the top surface, theta equal to 0 degree. You know cos 0 is equal to 1. Now here I have curved surface. You consider one small area, that is dA. You draw one normal. Now dA becomes dA vector. This is my E line and this is my N cap line. The angle between these two are 90 degree. So here at the curved surface, theta is equal to 90 degree. The bottom portion is embedded inside the conductor. So inside the conductor, E is equal to 0. Here E is equal to 0 means the integral vanishes. Here cos 90 is equal to 0. So this is also 0. So what is your conclusion? Top surface contributes to electric flux. Then how do you write? That is phi is equal to E integral dA, that is equal to Q by epsilon naught. Integral of dA can be written as A. Then how do you write sigma? Sigma is nothing but surface charge density. Here plus Q charges are uniformly distributed on the surface of the conductor. That is why I am introducing surface charge density sigma. Surface charge density means charge per unit area. Suppose I want Q, means you can get sigma A, substitute in this equation. So EA, that is equal to sigma A divided by epsilon naught. Cancel, you can get E is equal to sigma by epsilon naught. This is magnitude. Suppose if you want to write in the vector format, means E vector is equal to sigma by epsilon naught n cap. What is this n cap? N cap is unit vector. Fourth property, electrostatic potential has same value on the surface and inside the conductor. Just now we have seen the tangential component of electric field is not possible. E is always normal to the surface of the conductor. Suppose the potential, electrostatic potential, is same at all the points on the conductor, means no work is required to move a charge on the surface of the conductor. See, just to recall the first property of equipotential surface, the work done to move a charge between any two points, W is equal to Va minus Vb. Suppose the potential is same, which means Va equal to Vb means the potential difference is zero. Potential difference is zero means the work done is also zero. That is why I said the potential, electrostatic potential, is same at all the points on the conductor, means no work is required to move a charge on the surface of the conductor. We know that E is equal to zero inside the conductor, right? This is our first property. Potential is same as the surface of the conductor. So what is our conclusion? At electrostatic equilibrium, the conductor is at equipotential. In this class, we discussed about what is conductor, what is electrostatic equilibrium condition. At electrostatic equilibrium, there is no net current inside the conductor. Then we discussed four properties. First property is E is equal to zero inside the conductor, whether the conductor is solid or hollow. Then second property is the net charge inside the conductor is zero. For this we used Gauss law. So inside the conductor, Q is equal to zero, E is also zero, then the flux phi is equal to zero. And third point, the electric field outside the conductor is perpendicular to the surface. Suppose tangential component of electric field, horizontal component of electric field, means we can get current in that direction. This contradicts our electrostatic equilibrium condition. So we concluded that electric field is always perpendicular to the surface of the conductor. This is our third point. Fourth one, electrostatic potential has same value on the surface and inside the conductor. Suppose the potential is same at all the points, means the work done, W, is equal to zero, because the potential difference is zero. Why? Because all are in the equipotential. So Va is equal to Vb, the potential difference is zero. At electrostatic equilibrium, the conductor is at equipotential. I hope this video is useful to you. If you like my video, please share and subscribe my video. Thank you.